Namaskar. Welcome to this module on Ayush Hospitals. In architecture, we talk about healing environments, smart, safe, green, and evidence-based hospitals. So, what are we talking about? In a multicultural, multifaceted country, traditional medicines have evolved over centuries, and we are blessed with a plethora of traditional medicines and practices. The Central Council of Ayurveda Research was established as an advisory body in 1962. The Central Council for Research in Indian Medicine and Homeopathy, CCRIMNH, was established in 1969. An independent identity under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare was created for the Indian systems of medicines and homeopathy, ISMNH, in 1995. It was renamed Department of Ayush, Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy in November 2003. The Department of Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy was formally called the Department of Indian Systems of Medicines and Homeopathy, ISMNH. Ayush is the latest statutory effort in the series of attempts at receiving traditional medicines in India. Ayush refers to non-allopathic medicinal systems in India, includes Indian medicinal systems of Ayurveda, Yoga and Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. The Department of Ayush under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare promotes, propagates the Indian systems of medicine and homeopathy. Ayurveda. Ayurveda is the classical system of healthcare originating from the Vedas, documented around 5,000 years ago. Basics of Ayurveda are: all objects and living bodies are composed of five basic elements called the Panch Bhutas, namely Akasha, Jal, Agni, Prithvi and Vayu. Ayurveda theory of Tridosha, with ether plus air, pith, fire and cup, earth and water. Psychologically, the entities in living beings are responsible for all metabolic functions. So, what is the aim? The aim in Ayurveda is to keep structural and functional entities in a good state of equilibrium. That is good health, swasthya. The cause of imbalance, the internal or external factors that lead to disturbance in natural equilibrium, which gives rise to diseases. The treatment is to restore the equilibrium through various procedures, regimes, diets, and non-allopathic medicines. So, what are the preventive measures? Swasthya, with that includes personal hygiene, modifying daily regimes and use of materials and practices for healthy aging. So, the curative treatment is Aushadhi, Ahara and Vihara, which is the drug, the lifestyle and what you eat. So, Ayurveda uses plants as raw materials for drugs and manufacturing through materials of animal and marine origin. Metals and minerals are also used. So, the effective treatment of chronic, metabolic and lifestyle diseases is done by Ayurveda. The most popular therapies are Panchakarma, a therapeutic procedure for radical elimination of disease-causing factors. The therapy minimizes chances of reoccurrence of the diseases and promotes positive health and regenerating body tissues and biopurification. The five detoxification processes used to treat diseases according to Ayurveda are the medicinal, emesis, the medicinal purification, the medicinal enema, and the medication through the root of nose or blood letting. So, a parasurgical intervention using an alkaline thread for the cessation, which scientifically validated to be effective treatment of fistula in anemia, such surgical conditions requires the excretion of overgrown soft tissues, non-healing chronic ulcers, etc. Yoga and naturopathy. Yoga is derived from the Sanskrit word yoj, which is unite and integrate, union of a person's own consciousness and universal consciousness. Yoga is a promotive, preventive, rehabilitative, and curative intervention for the overall enhancement of health status. It consists of 8 components, namely restraint, yama, observation of austerity, physical postures, which is asana, breathing exercises, which is pranayama, restraining the sense organs, and dharma, medication, and deep meditation, which is samadhi. Regular practice of yoga improves the social and personal behavior and promotes physical health by better circulation of oxygen in the body, restraining the sense organs and thereby inducing tranquility and serenity of mind. Yoga is also useful in prevention of certain psychosomatic diseases, thus improves the individual's resistance and ability to live through the stressful situations in life. Naturopathy. Better health without medicines. By living in harmony with the constructive principles of nature on physical, mental, moral, and spiritual planes. This promotes healing by stimulating the body's inherent power to regain health with the help of 5 elements of nature, that is earth, water, air, fire, and ether. Effective in chronic allergic, autoimmune and stress-related disorders, based on a holistic viewpoint with attention to simple eating and living habits, fasting. Hydrotherapy, body packs, baths, mud packs, massages, underwater exercises, air therapy, magnetic therapy, chromotherapy, acupuncture, acupressure, etc. are used. Now we come to Yunani. Yunani originated in Greece. Foundation of Yunani system of medicine was laid by Hippocrates, introduced in India by the Arabs and the Persians sometime around the 11th century. During the 13th to the 17th century AD, Yunani medicine had its heyday in India, based upon the well-known 4 humor therapies of Hippocrates. Human body is considered to be made up of 7 components: the elements, the temperament, the humors, the organs, the spirits or vital breaths, the energy, and the functions. So Yunani, the effective conditions like rheumatoid arthritis, jaundice, nervous debility, skin diseases like vertigo and eczema, sinuses and bronchial asthma. So the emphasis in Yunani is on pure air, food and water, physical movements and rest, psychic movement, rest, sleep and wakefulness, and retention of useful materials and evacuation of waste materials from the body. Yunani medicine treatments are Haj, Bid, Dawa, which is the pharmacotherapy, Haj, Bil, Gaza, Haj, Bid, Tadbir, and Haj, Bil, Jarat, which is the surgery or surgical treatment. Siddha. Siddha meaning achievement. The ancient system of medicine in India, in close blend with the Dravidian culture, emphasizes on the patient's environment, age, sex, race, habits, mental framework, habitat, diet, appetite, physical condition, psychological constitution of the disease for its treatment, which is individualistic in nature. Diagnosis is done through the examination of pulse, urine, eyes, study of voice, color of body, tongue, status of the digestion of individual patients. The system has unique treasure for the conversion of metals and minerals as drugs, and many ineffective diseases are treated with a medicine containing specially processed mercury, silver, arsenic, lead, sulfur without any side effects. Effective therapy in the case of psoriasis, rheumatoid disorders, chronic liver diseases, prostate hypertrophy, bleeding piles, peptic ulcers, and various kinds of dermatological disorders of non-proristic nature. Homeopathy. Homeopathy was brought into India around 1810 AD by European missionaries and received official recognition in 1948 by the Parliament. Principles of homeopathy. The first principle, similia similibus curator, a medicine which could induce a set of symptoms in healthy human beings would be capable of curing a similar set of symptoms in human beings actually suffering from the disease. The second principle, simple medicine, should be administered at a time to a particular patient during the treatment. Third principle, minimum dose, bare minimum dose of a drug, which would induce a curative action without any adverse effect, should be administered. Based on the assumption of causation of a disease mainly depends upon the susceptibility or proneness of an individual to the incidence of the particular disease, in addition to the action of external agents like bacteria, viruses, etc. Medicines are prepared mainly from natural substances such as plant products, minerals, and from animal sources. Medicines are useful in treatment for allergies, autoimmune disorders, and viral infections. Many surgical, gynecological, and obstetrical and pediatric conditions and ailments affecting the eyes, nose, ear, teeth, skin, sexual organs, etc. can be controlled by therapeutic treatment. Behavioral disorders, neurological problems, and metabolic diseases can also be successfully treated by homeopathy. Homeopathic medicines are also used in preventive and promotive health care. Objectives of Ayush hospitals: to upgrade the educational standards in the Indian systems of medicines and homeopathy colleges in the country, to strengthen the existing research institutions and ensure a time-bound research program on identified diseases for which these systems have an effective treatment, to draw upon schemes for promotion, cultivation, regulation of medicinal plants used in these systems, to create and spread awareness by effective communication strategies to reach all sections of people, to evolve the pharmacopoeial standards for Indian systems of medicine and homeopathic drugs, to supplement state government efforts in setting up specialty clinics of Ayush in allopathic hospitals and Ayush wing in district allopathic hospitals. Infrastructure. Ayush sector contains 3,193 hospitals with about 56,842 beds, 24,280 dispensaries, 712,121 doctors, 510 educational institutions with an admission capacity of about 25,376 UG students and 22,008 PG students and about 8,898 drug manufacturing units. Under the National Rural Health Mission, Ayush facilities have been co-located with 416 district hospitals. Out of a total of 605, 2,942 community health centers, out of a total of 4,535, and 9,559 primary health centers, out of a total of 23,673 in the country by the year 2011. So, what are the design guidelines for Ayush hospitals? The Indian Public Health Standards, which are the IPHS norms for healthcare services in India, with the intention and initiation of the National Rural Health Mission in India, the first set of standards were released in 2007 and the second revised set were released in 2012. Among the various services, Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha, Homeopathy, Ayush is one of the components, and certain standards have also been prescribed for Ayush facilities in the concerned health institutions. The physical infrastructure of an Ayurvedic central hospital space requirements are: so the clinic is minimum of 100 square feet, dispensary is a minimum of again 100 square feet, the therapy center is minimum of 150 square feet, hospitals with 10 beds is around 100 square feet per bed, which is around 500 square feet, hospitals up to 11 to 25 beds and OPD up to 250 square feet and IPD 1250 square feet. So from 25 to 50 beds with the OPD of 500, so the area is 2500 square feet. So for 51 to 100 beds, the OPD is 1,000 square feet and IPD is 5,000 square feet. Hospitals having more than 100 beds, the OPD is 2,500 square feet and the IPD is 7,500 square feet. So, the reception and waiting area. For clinics, it is around 50 square feet for every 10 beds. For hospitals, more than 50 beds situated at the main entrance at the reception. Subsidiary waiting areas for the patients at each clinic, diagnostic area, therapy rooms for hospitals having more than 5 OPDs. Waiting area should be tiled floors with comfortable benches and chairs. Waiting areas should be used for health education, adequate toilet facilities as per the load of the patients with one urinal for 50 persons. Provisions should be made for wheelchairs, trolleys, and the areas should be well illuminated. Medical record room requires a minimum of 100 square feet space for medical records of the OPD for hospitals more than 50 beds where records of both OPD and IPD patients can be maintained. Consultation and examination rooms, one doctor's chamber of 10 feet by 10 feet size, a dressing room, minimum of 100 square feet space, optimal for hospitals below 50 beds and clinics. Procedure room, it is required in hospitals having more than 100 bed strength where Agnikarma, Shrakarma like procedures can be performed for OPD patients. Minor OTs, for hospitals more than 50 beds and 400 to 500 outpatient floor where minor OPD surgical procedures as well as Shrakshutra applications can be performed. Minimum area required is 100 square feet. Others, one can develop specialty clinics such as diabetic clinic, skin clinic, Rasayana and Vajaykarna clinic along with special therapy rooms for Rakt Mokshana as per the space availability in the OPD blocks. The general specifications for OPD, the basic infrastructure for an outpatient department are reception and waiting hall, registration counter, OPD medical records room, clinics, consultation rooms, dressing room mandatory for hospitals more than 50 beds, procedure room mandatory for hospitals more than 50 beds, minor OT optional but mandatory for hospitals more than 100 beds, dispensary mandatory for hospitals more than 50 beds. Other facilities which are required in the OPD are proper provision for drinking water and electricity, toilet facilities for patients, OPD cafeteria, outdoor patients departments. Available in an Ayurvedic hospital are, the hospital shall have a minimum of 8 of the following outpatients departments: Kaya Chikitsa, general medicine of the body, Panchkarma physiotherapy, Shalya Tantra surgery, Shalya Kriya Tantra two rooms for outpatient department, Netra Rog Vibhaga ophthalmology, Karnanasa Mukha MM Danta Rog Vibhag ENT and dentistry, Prasuti MM Stri Rog gynecology and obstetrics, Kumara Vritya Bal Roga pediatrics, Swastha Vritta Evam Yoga social and preventive medicine, Atyayika emergency. General specification for IPD classification of ward accommodation, primarily bed accommodation, nursing station, treatment room, secondary doctor's room, nurse's room, clean utility, sanitary, toilet block, dirty utility, housekeeping, ancillary, kitchen required for hospitals having more than 50 beds, day room, stretcher bay. Area per bed must be 50 square feet per bed with a minimum distance between two beds is 3.5 feet and the minimum distance between two rows of bed must be 5 feet. One nurse's station in between two wards with a minimum of 100 square feet dimension with one nurse for every 10 beds. Circulation area of at least 200 square feet per 25 beds. As a general guideline, in case of Ayurveda specialty hospitals, the facilities available should be in proportion and appropriate with the nature of service provided. The services provided at the hospital shall be consistent with the principles of classical Ayurveda. Doctor's duty room must have a minimum of 100 square feet dimension. inpatient department available in an Ayurvedic hospital are Kaya Chikitsa and Panchakarma, Shalya, Shalakya, Prasuti, Balaroga. The indoor departments of the hospital shall have separate male and female wards. An ideal distribution of the beds shall be as follows, which you can see in the diagram which we are showing you on the screen now. The operating theater should be 2700 square feet, mandatory for hospitals having more than 100 beds, optional for hospitals below 100 beds. The functional distributions are as follows: major OT with attached toilets and bathrooms, minor OTs with scrub rooms, sterilization store, equipment store, recovery room. The labor room shall be 300 square feet for 100 bedded hospital with duty room. It is optional for hospitals below 100 bed strength. Neonatal care room of 150 square feet for 100 bedded hospitals. Again, this is optional. Panchakarma unit, an area of 2000 square feet for hospitals having 100 beds and more. However, hospitals having 51 to 100 beds, the space requirement is approximately 1000 square feet, and hospitals having more than 50 bed space requirement is approximately 500 square feet. Hospitals having 25 beds or 10 beds can have space as per the requirement and is optional for hospitals up to 25 beds. Specifications is listed below for hospitals more than 100 beds. You can see in the slide enclosed which is giving you the names of the rooms for males and females. Auxiliary facilities. Central laboratory. It must be located where it is easily accessible for all, ideally in between the OPD and the IPD blocks. It may have facility for clinical pathology, microbiology, biochemistry and histopathology, separate sections for collection, media preparation, sterilization and storage should be made, provision for waiting area, toilet facilities and distribution of lab results counters. Area required for the central lab must be 1200 square feet for hospitals having more than 100 beds. For hospitals below 50 beds, they may tie up with other labs. Radiology. The minimum area required for X-ray unit is 150 square meters for hospitals having more than 100 beds. It is optional for hospital below 100 beds. Space can be functionally divided into radiographer room, X-ray room, dark room, drying room, waiting area and report distribution area. An X-ray record room is required for teaching and training hospitals. Support services and supplies include dietary services, water supply, electricity, toilet facilities, laundry service, housekeeping and sanitation, medicine preparation area, ambulance services, circulation, medical records, waste management. Ayurvedic specialty hospitals, hospitals attached with medical education or apex hospitals for Ayurveda can extend their services to the population by developing specialty clinics like diabetic, cardiovascular, dermatology, respiratory, geriatrics and neuromuscular, etc. They can also develop separate Panchakarma unit for Balaroga in indoor. They can develop deluxe and private ward as per the influx of patients. Sustainable planning for an Ayurvedic hospital. Location. Select a plot of sufficient space for its infrastructure facilities and is easily accessible by road. Space requirement. The minimum space required for a 100-bedded hospital should be a minimum of 20,000 square feet covered area. It should accommodate an outpatients department and inpatients departments, in addition to reception area, waiting areas, dispensing room, dressing room, clinical laboratory, radiology section, side pharmacy, kitchen, service rooms, medical record rooms, Panchakarma therapy section, Sar Sutra therapy section, operation theater, labor room, store rooms, separate wards for male and female patients, duty rooms for doctors, nurses and other staff. The building design should allow good amount of daylight and ventilation to enter the living spaces. Disabled and elderly friendly building should be designed. Flooring should use eco-friendly tiles. These tiles improves the performance of indoor environment quality. Eco-friendly bricks. Fly ash and iron ore tailings are the waste products from iron industries that should be dumped by the industries as their byproduct. Nowadays, fly ash bricks are easily available in cheaper cost and can be used as an alternative for the conventional bricks. Sustainable planning for an Ayurvedic hospital. Fabrics for bed sheets, curtains, fabrics produced by aloe vera, jute, bamboo, banana, cotton. The artificial fabric materials are used by everyone exclusively as clothes, curtains, bed sheets, etc. In hospitals and therapeutic centers, artificial fibers cause allergies to several people and also they are not good for health. Besides that, after their disposal, they are causing pollution and thus harm to the environment. Fabrics made from eco fabrics can be worn by one and all as they do not have any irritating chemicals in them. Hence, the usage of eco fabrics and organic fabrics are the best solution to keep our earth clean and to minimize the global warming. Paints, VOC free paints. VOC components in hospitals and workspaces can negatively affect the health. Household things such as tables, chairs, wardrobes, paints on wall contains harmful chemicals that contain volatile organic compounds. VOCs which are toxic in nature. So, to make an Ayurvedic hospital eco-friendly, healthy and environmentally safe, alternatives such as low or zero VOC paints should be used. Yoga and meditation spaces. Most of the yoga take place in a large open central space, accompanied by a set of support rooms. The main room in the central space of the building where people gather for practice are generally is a free plan, flexible and adaptable to different uses. We can use standard measures of a yoga mat to determine its dimension, which unfolds fully stretched in an area of approximately 1.7 into 0.6 meters, leaving at least 50 centimeters between the mats to allow for free movement of users during the exercises. Some of these rooms have a small platform or elevated area where the instructor or guide of the session is located, and it is good to add shelves or countertops where people can leave their tools during the class. Water bottles, towels, blankets, sleepers. Usually the room has mirrors on one or more walls, but this depends on the needs and the taste of the clients. Minimum standards for Siddha establishments. Clinic. Area requirement is 80 square feet. Outdoor care facility managed by a single Siddha medical practitioner or a group of Siddha practitioners with or without a daycare facility. No overnight stay or care is provided here. Dispensary. The area requirement is 100 square feet. Outdoor care facility managed by a single Siddha medical practitioner or a group of Siddha practitioners with or without daycare facility along with dispensing unit. No overnight stay or care is provided here. Therapy center. Area requirement 200 square feet. Outdoor care facility managed by a single Siddha medical practitioner or a group of Siddha practitioners with or without a daycare facility, providing at least any one of the 32 external therapies or special therapies. Care is provided by Siddha medical practitioner or a group of Siddha medical practitioners qualified in the concerned system of medicine, having graduate or postgraduate qualifications. So there are facilities with no beds, up to 10 beds or 11 to 25 beds. Healthcare facilities with 11 to 25 beds for indoor care and the ability to monitor and treat patients requiring overnight stay, care is provided by a group of Siddha medical practitioners qualified in the concerned system of medicine, having graduate or postgraduate qualifications. 26 to 50 beds. Healthcare facility with 26 to 50 beds for indoor care and ability to monitor and treat patients requiring overnight stay. Care is provided by a group of Siddha medical practitioners qualified in the concerned system of medicine, having graduate or postgraduate qualifications. 51 to 100 beds. Healthcare facility having more than 51 to 100 beds for indoor care and ability to monitor and treat patients requiring an overnight stay, care is provided by a group of Siddha medical practitioners qualified in the concerned system of medicine, having graduate or postgraduate qualification. More than 100 beds. Healthcare facility with 101 beds and above for indoor care and ability to monitor and treat patients requiring overnight stay, care is provided by a group of Siddha medical practitioners qualified in the concerned system of medicine, having graduate or postgraduate qualifications. Thank you. Namaskar. I hope the module on Ayush gives you an introduction to this systems of medicines. You'll have to study our reference materials to understand the concepts fully. Namaskar.